Lord that worked all months, all week, and all day with me to make sure this happens. And I think everybody could agree with me that this has been a nice gathering so far. At least the food was good. So those of you that are here as a guest that don't know what's going on, we hosted this for the soccer party, basically awareness and to give some awards for some people.
You are different level, but you have to go further, you have to learn. Especially the ladies.
Alright,
especially the ladies and the guys. You need to think, you are the future of this community. We are waiting you. You are the leaders of tomorrow. So please, try to understand that. So please, I'm begging you also, you need to pray. Because prayer is the main thing for your life. You have to pray. The prayer will lead you to a good place, not a bad place. When you start when you are young to pray, that's the good. Because now we are praying, and I see some guys really sitting alive and making a joke. But you didn't make a joke. But doesn't mean I'm young, I will not die. Really, you will die. Young and old, you have to take the die. The die. One day you're going to die. So I am begging you guys, please. And I already met my thing, as I say, if I'm my English broken, please, I'm sorry. So please, try to pray, try to remember. Because what I'm telling you today, that's what I have supposed to tell you. Because that's what God has made me to tell you. Because God said, yeah, you're not from this woman here from Nara. Everybody tell your relatives and your people that there is a fire, that fire which will be people who one day there will be fire. So please, there's a grace. And you know one of your friends, and he was not your friend, but he was one of them was with just a body the other day. So doesn't mean if you are young, you will not die, like all people always die. So please try to pray, try to practice your religion, because Muslim is the right religion, it's the main thing for everybody. So today you are young, but you can grow old one day. So please think, and I'm sorry if I made some mistake, assalamu alaikum.
Salim or Magasha, Salim, can you hear me, Mr. September, welcome?
Thank you very much. You keep our home. Thank you very much. I will add the other thing, my dear.
Abdul Rahman, please clap for him. I'm really excited for all you guys to be here today. It's really been a great day. How are you guys doing? I want to say a few things. First of all, really happy for you guys to be here first. And we would love to see more of this, like this, us coming together as a Somali Monkey Community Center, us getting together. The more we get together and the more we come together, the more that we can achieve, personally. I want to congratulate some of the women in here, especially Seiko. Congratulations, Seiko. This is it, the way we're coming together, building as a community center. I like the way it's going. We the future. Let's not be our parents. We the future. So let's get together just like that. And Asha, congratulations for you, for us to be there for every game, supporting us through the whole team. And I also would like to congratulate my coach right there, Musa, for this whole season. Well, that's all I'm going to end it. For the young kids right now, the prim. I was really excited last week. I'm in the class ranking. I was really excited last week. I seen a kid that I never seen playing soccer before. Because some of their friends play for the prim and they decided to join, living the street life. And that is a really a good thing, and that is our main priority to get the little kids out from the street, away from the drugs, because as a community, we want our kids to be safe also. And thank you very much, and thank you all of you for being here. It has really been a great day. As you guys know, there's two teams here. We have two Kentucky teams. We have what we call Kentucky Star Classic. That's a team with the older guys. I myself involved, Abyssa and everybody else. And then we also have another team with the guys, the youth that are all coming up. We call it Kentucky Star Premier. And I'm going to go ahead and call two of the captains, and they're going to give a little bit of speech, and then we go from there. I'm going to go ahead, Yusuf Quran.
Just especially thank you all the girls for coming, you know. that we know in Kentucky and stuff. So we just hope, we just see a bunch of y'all's presence in the future too, so that can just, you know, come out and support us as a team and, you know, as a family too, because most of us here are related, you know. You know how that works, but. But anyways, you know, just thank, I also thank our coach of Bill too for, like, you know, actually giving us a chance of us, like, younger guys actually coming together and getting a team together too, because, like, we've always been, like, you know, asking our team together forever, but, like, it's just, you know, we never had, like, the support, but now, you know, we have our team set up and everything, so we just want to thank everybody for that. So, you know, but, yeah, thank y'all for coming, and hopefully in the future we can see more of y'all faces at our games, too, so thank you for coming, y'all.
I could tell you it's tough and it's very stressful to put something like this together, And without them, we would not be here. We'd all be starving by now. And thank God I'm full. I have stuff in my stomach because of those two people, three people that helped us. Because Musa and I don't know if you guys would have ate our cooking. But, guys, I know, listen, I know Mr. Saite a few things, and he was right about some things. I think the future is bright between the girls, the boys, everyone. I think we have a pretty bright future on us young people. And it's a very happy thing to see everybody here. Everybody here, our friends, cousins, family, whatever it is, everybody's here enjoying themselves. And we really don't want this to be our last one. We want this to be the beginning of many things to come. We want everybody to be involved. We want to, I don't know if the girls have something going on. We want to be there to help out. And we want the girls to help out the soccer team. We want to be together as united, as a community. So one thing we could do is, you know, I know things are advancing and a lot of people are in higher educational level nowadays. If the girls have some ideas about the community, please, everybody's open to it. We're not thinking conservatively like our parents. We're here to make sure that if you have ideas, we're available to them. If you have ideas, there's no such thing as a bad idea. There's an idea that we will take and the one we won't take. But we will hear you out, I promise. If you have any idea, do not shy. Even if you don't want to say it, write it on a piece of paper. Do not name it. I don't know. Put it in a mailbox here or something. We want to make sure everybody's involved with us moving forward together. I don't care how old you are. Young, old, everybody has a brain. If you have something in the brain that I don't have, I want to hear it. And one thing I would encourage, especially the women, is if you're asking this question, like, how can I help? You know, like today we only have three people that were helping with cooking. Maybe next time we have this party, we'll have 15 people. You could be one of those people that showcase your cooking, something like that. So, or a fundraiser for the soccer team. You can, yeah, get together, do something, whatever it is. And we, as you guys know, last Thanksgiving, I know Asha, Zay Tu, and them, Bakron, they know that we hosted a tournament that's going to be hosting every Thanksgiving from now on. Especially Zay Tu, she was a very big help. Without her, I think everything would have been a mess. I'm so glad that she was there to help us out. But next year coming, I think we can get more girls. If we can get more and more people to help out, I don't care if you put in 30 minutes, so 30 hours, and still, any help we can get will be fine in terms of going, moving forward together. And hopefully we can come to a great understanding moving forward, and maybe we can build some women's group. I don't know, we've been trying to get something together for the girls. I don't know what kind of ideas you girls have in terms of getting the girls together. I know we have the guys together in two teams. Everybody, we have a set of rules, everybody follows all that. And if you guys have something that girls would do, any ideas, we're open to it. We will help you make it happen. We want to build this community from going forward. And we want to build it to where everybody's ideas are welcome. We're not going to shut the doors on anybody. We're not going to say, oh, we're not going to listen to that because of the girls. I don't care how old you are. As you can see, this is a lot of everybody here are young people. And as moving forward, we need each other. Everybody is needed to move this community forward. And together, I think we can make a lot of great things happen in the future. And Mr. Saeed said, a lot of us are parents, we're young, and that could shape up how people view Bantu people in the future. Because we're going to raise our kids right, hopefully. And we're going to be better parents in terms of educating and making sure that we're going to be proud we are as Somali Bantu people. And we're going to God have more gathering like this. And we're going to be supportive of each other. An example of that is someone like Issa. Issa, a very good cameraman. He basically volunteered to come do this for us. But of course, as brothers and sisters, Musa and I, we're going to make sure Issa's paid for his hard work. And this is coming for anybody. Anybody that has any kind of skill set that we could use, we're willing to go use, whether it's in a store. store or whatever it is, we're willing to keep our money in the Malibatu community. So someone like Issa, if you have a family photos or whatever you need your kid's birthday to be recorded, this is the man you go to. We encourage that. Yes, he charges, that's his job. So is everybody else.
Thank you.
And same stuff like that. You know, I know some of you girls, you guys do makeup, Hannah. You know, maybe if my daughter needs a makeup or not, I can call one of you guys, pay you. Stuff like that. That is a way we can support each other moving forward. And all this is coming from the bottom of my heart because I'm very proud. For the past couple of years, I've never been more proud to be part of a youth in Kentucky, to be part of a Somali Bantu. And moving forward, I want to make sure everybody has a say in this community. And I know some of you guys are shy, but you guys have some really intelligent stuff hidden in your brain. We want those things out. We want to use them to better ourselves. A lot of you girls, sometimes some of the countries, the most successful countries in the world, even the United States, some of the greatest ideas coming from women. So please do not be shy. If you have good ideas, you think you have, you know, set up good ideas or something that we can do as a community, if you're shy, if you don't want anybody to know, even just write it on a piece of paper, don't write any name on it, whatever, put it in the mailbox. Just please give it to us. And moving forward, hopefully we can come together, we can make more events happen. And as for last, I want to thank most of the women here are either wives of some of the players and the coaches. We know soccer takes a lot of time from your men. We know that. My wife can tell you a lot about that. Soccer takes a lot of time. We know. And that's why we have an event like this, so we can say thank you for letting me go to soccer. Thank you for letting me come home late, 3 in the morning, because I was at soccer. Thank you for letting me be out on the weekends, because I'm too busy playing soccer in the middle of nowhere. So stuff like that, we're not taking it for granted. We just want to say thank you. And we want you guys to be on board, to be fully supportive. Because moving forward, I think soccer has done a lot for this community. I don't know, most people don't know, but it brought a lot of us together. And we want to continue that. And maybe 15 years from now, we'll be sitting here. It won't be me, maybe one of you all's kids, maybe my kids, giving the same speech. And that's the kind of future we're looking for, inshallah. Everything will get there with the help of Allah, inshallah. And from now on, I will take it to Kabisa, and thank you for your time. Guys, so this guy doesn't need any introduction. He's one of the members in the community. So the community is open. It's guys like these that are doing overtime behind the scene. And we just want to recognize because this place is available to us. We're able to throw a party here. And people like this monthly pay rent to this place so we can have stuff like this happen. So please welcome them. I'm sure they have a little bit of word to say. And give your full attention to them, please.
Sigan wal iman yang berzikir about in the near future. I would like to thank each and everyone who came out here, supported the youth league, the soccer players, and the community. And I hope you guys will continue doing it over and over and over again. This way we come together, and inshallah we will achieve our common goal in the near future. Thank you for all coming. And by the way, I have an idea, but I see some food out there. I like it. Those who hard work, thank you for bringing the food here for your players and for everybody out here. Thank you. And probably we'll see more of you.
Your friends, your husbands, boyfriend, whatever. And then please come by, sit down.